Most friends of Spears Business are aware that the new business building will be finished in the spring of 2018. If you're looking for more details, Lisa Fain is your best bet. Fain is the Director of Operations at Spears Business, and she serves as its liaison to the building project. She has been involved in nearly every step of the project.
I was so thrilled when Dean Eastman asked me to do that. To me, it's just such a vote of confidence that he had in me.
Fain began her career at OSU in 1986, when she worked at the Edmund Lowe Library as a financial coordinator for 19 years. She and her husband, Jim Fain, professor in the Spears School's Department of Economics and Legal Studies, met at the University of Texas, where she got her bachelor's degree in business management. They came to OSU to be as close as possible to their home state of Texas, but stayed because of the welcoming community.
So I've been at OSU 30 years. I've kind of grown up at OSU professionally. Also, our family has grown up here. My husband and I moved here 30 years ago, and we had two sons, both who are proud OSU graduates, one from the Spears School and one from the College of Engineering. So we're very proud of them that they chose to stay here too, that they decided that OSU was the place where they wanted to get their education. We've just found that Stillwater and OSU has been a great place to raise our family.
Fain's main role as the project liaison is to make sure the organization and setup of the new building will function right for Spears Business. Her role is unique in that she gets to advocate for students, faculty, staff, and alumni in the construction meetings. However, it's not always an easy job.
One of the greatest challenges for me is that I want to make sure that we're pleasing everybody. And when you have that many people and that many different groups of people, students and faculty and staff and alums and donors, that there's a lot of people to please.
Flexibility is another challenge in the project. The new building will need to be able to withstand the test of time while also being flexible enough for future upgrades.
We've really tried to make sure that the building is a 60, 70-year-old building, that it will last us and that we can modify it as things change. You just never know how instruction's going to change and how we do things change. And so we've tried to design the building where it's very easy for us to put up a different wall or to take down a wall, and things can change. We don't have to do a major construction just to change parts of the building.
Although there are a few challenges, Fain loves the opportunity to be involved in such a huge project. She's even learned a few things along the way.
I've learned a little bit about construction, and when I mean little, I mean little. But it's been fun because they tease me about learning all of the terms. And so I've learned about GFRC, and I've learned about high wind refuge, and I've heard all these different terms. And sometimes after the meetings, I have to go back to my office and Google it because I can't know what they're talking about.
Fain looks forward to the day she walks through the nearly 150,000 square foot building and sees students and faculty interacting with one another under the same roof for the first time in years. She says watching the building take form and helping with the project has been a great experience.
Everybody's been anxiously awaiting the start of the building, and each phase of it just draws us closer and closer to having that reality. First, it was tearing down Hanner Hall, and then the stacks, or the educational wing of our building, and then starting to see the new building come up from the ground. And so each step just gets us more and more excited that it really is going to happen, and that we really are going to have this wonderful facility that we can work in.